Hey, I'm Angela Sharpe, and welcome to The Daily Mix. You don't know what The Daily Mix is all about? I'm gonna tell you everything that's going on in and around St. Louis, basically keeping you in the mix, right? All right, now one of these fun facts about me is that I love the movie Back to the Future 2. That's the one where Marty McFly goes into the future. Well, in that movie, he goes to the year 2015. Hello, we're in 2015. And one of the really cool things that they have in 2015 is a hoverboard. Well, Lexus released a teaser video with their hoverboard. Now, they have released this Back to the Future style hoverboard using what they call magnetic levitation. They've got liquid nitrogen cooled superconductors and permanent magnets, giving it a frictionless movement, which all sounds kind of futuristic itself. They say they're gonna start doing development in about 18 months. However, we've yet to actually see anyone on it. So that's gonna be interesting. Now they say this is gonna be kind of modeled after the Lexus cars, cause you know, there's a lot of hoverboards around and they're gonna start testing this in Barcelona in the coming weeks. What's really cool about this is they said that we could see some hoverboards around October, and that would be pretty timely for the whole Back to the Future thing. Also, if you really are a big fan of Back to the Future, the Cubs play Miami in the World Series. Miami has a team, and right now the Cubs are, gonna possibly make the playoffs. So hey, maybe it's all coming true. Maybe 2015 is Marty McFly's 2015. We just need flying cars. Did you check out the VMAs last night? Now, a lot of people watch the VMAs. Miley Cyrus was the host, and of course she wore tons of crazy outfits that only Miley could pull off. I actually really like her crazy outfits. If I was that thin, I would wear that right here, but they probably wouldn't let me on the show, but that's okay. You know, there's a lot of talk, there's some things going back and forth. Kanye said he's going to run for president in 2020. Remind me not to vote for him. Also, was that a setup between Miley and Nicki Minaj? Was that a setup or was that real, that fight? Some people on Facebook say it was a setup. Who knows? And like talking about Facebook, 1 billion people use Facebook on the same day for the first time ever. Now, obviously Facebook has a lot of people there, but this is a milestone for them. It happened on Monday. They say 1 in 7 people on Earth, why do we specify on Earth? Like, as opposed to Mars, on Earth use Facebook. Now, Facebook has 1.5 billion users anyway, but this is the first time they've logged on a single day. Now, there's no saying what they posted. I'm sure it was a lot of pictures of people's food, because that's what we care about, your food and your kids. Keep posting that. Okay, let's get started on today's Daily Mix. Well, I sure hope you had a great weekend. I had a wonderful weekend. In fact, yesterday was the Blues Icebreaker event. Now, this is the second year the St. Louis Blues have had an Icebreaker event. We're calling it Icebreaker 2015. And basically, each of us get fans ready for the upcoming season. This is the second year, and the second year we have hit capacity. There I am right there on your screen. I was the host, the MC for the evening. So I played some games with fans and that kind of fun stuff going on. I also shot a video that'll be featured later on at a Blues game. And as you can see, tons of Blues fans showed up. There was a red carpet. I don't know if you can kind of see it right there on that screen, on that photo, that the players walked down. Petrangelo was there, Tarasenko, and of course, David Backes were all in attendance. Got to talk to some of the fans and actually gave away their jerseys too. It's a really, really cool event. And by cool, I mean awesome, because it was really, really hot in the building. And it just shows you how passionate Blues fans are, as most of them were wearing their Blues sweaters, sweating to death, but they were very excited to be there. We're very excited for the upcoming season. And speaking of the upcoming season, Blues forward Patrick Berglund will be out for 4 months. He is having surgery on his right shoulder. Now he re-injured it. He had injured it in Sweden and he re-injured it in training camp. He's expected to miss, the first half of the season before even being re-evaluated in December. So we've got those injuries. The Blues have announced that they're gonna invite some people to training camp. They've invited Scott Gomez. He's one of the five players who have accepted an invitation to training camp. And of course, you know, Ty Ratty and Fabry will all be there. So hey, maybe they'll actually make the team at the start of the year. That would be pretty cool. And can I just say, let's go Blues! You know, Google has been telling us what we're searching. Yeah, they keep track of that, right? So what do you think we're searching that's embarrassing? Well, this real estate search site, Estately, went through 11 years of Google searches, and they have made a list of what embarrassing and shameful things we are Googling by state. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? The Midwest has terrible taste in movies, apparently. And here are some of the things that we have been searching for in Missouri. George Foreman grill. Well, that's not that embarrassing. George Foreman's cool, and I have one of those grills, and that's awesome. And it like gets all your fat away, and it's pretty neat. And fake mustaches are also another thing that we've been Googling, apparently, in the Midwest and in Missouri. I'm not sure about the fake mustaches, but, I mean, why not? Now, if you live on the Illinois side, the Jerry Springer Show is something that you really, really want to Google a lot. And again, also a pretty cool dude, I gotta say. And people in Illinois want to know if the WWE is fake or not. I know a lot of people that are super passionate about the WWE, so don't tell them that it's fake. Southern Illinois University in Edwardsville is in Washington Monthly's top 40 for master's universities in the nation. It's the sixth consecutive year it made it. Now, this evaluates the schools based on some cool things like contribution to the public good, and in three categories such as social mobility, educating low-income students, and research producing cutting-edge scholarship and PhD services. It's encouraging students to give something back to their country. SIUE ranked 40th overall in the master's university category, which includes 643 public and private institutions, which is pretty awesome, so go them. And moving along to the next story on our here at the Daily Mix, four Missouri schools ranked among nation's 100 top colleges for businesses. Now this is by nerdwallet.com. It's a consumer finance website. Washington University ranked highest for schools here. It was number 13. That's pretty high actually. Now that a lot of people say that the university, Washington University is very, you know, expensive. However, they say you can get a lot of money, you know, off your college degree for different scholarships, and what you make once you graduate there is awesome. Then another school came in number 63, probably the University of Missouri Columbia. They came in 63. And another school came in 73. That would be at Northwest Missouri State University. They examined 358 of these U.S. universities, and those are the ones that made the list. Moving on to other awesome things happening here on the Daily Mix. There's gonna be some cool stuff for you. Let me tell you all about this cool stuff we got. St. Louis investors ranked among the savviest in the U.S. Now this is according to Smart Asset. It was a study and it ranks St. Louis 9th based on which investors get the highest return for the least risk. Now they use something called the Sharpe ratio. Not me sharp, but it's a different ratio, to calculate the risk adjusted. Now, the return on the stocks, as well as the amount of money investors put in after paying state and federal capital gains, that's how they did it. So hey, we're apparently super savvy, go us. Now, I know a lot of people are really excited that IKEA is set to open September 30th. Well, have you never been? I've never been. So the St. Louis Business Journal, well, a reporter went there and she's giving us some tips on how we can look at IKEA. All right, so here are the tips. Ready? Get your pen and paper out. There are doors located in the middle of a room setting. Those are actually shortcuts to get to another area of the store. So that's pretty cool. Apparently, you can buy meatballs at an IKEA, and there's gonna be three meatball options. Now, they're famous for their Swedish meatballs. So they will have that. But St. Louis store will also offer a vegetarian meatball and a chicken option as well. Now, I didn't know this at all, but you can apparently just drop your kids off. There's a play area right there at IKEA. You can drop your kids off while you shop. That's pretty neat. And remember, when you're shopping, to write down the item number of things you're interested in, because you have to go find your items downstairs in the warehouse before you can check out. Of course, we will keep you posted as the opening nears. I know a lot of people are very excited about that. Another thing people are excited about is Olive Supermarket. The RFT has 10 things to buy there. Now, first, let me tell you, the RFT also said that there are two types of people. People who have been and love the Olive Supermarket, and people who have never been. So, the never been people like me, listen up, this is what you should buy there. They have peeled garlic. They have an entire aisle of tea. They have hard to find greens, which is kind of cool. They're also known for their frozen dumplings, unique beer options, hot pot seasoning. Of course, there's party foods. There's green tea ice cream. Green tea ice cream, that sounds awesomely weird and I kind of want to try it. And they also have other odd gadgets. There's a bowl picker upper, there's old chicken. I don't know how old chicken is better than new chicken, but they've got it right there, old chicken, $3 to $9 each apparently. You can check that out. Thanks to a special request on STLtoday.com, Urban Chestnut is sharing, are you ready for this? Did you know that Urban Chestnut has deviled eggs? They sell deviled eggs there, that's right. And they're sharing their recipe. Now, if you're not familiar with Urban Chestnut, they're a craft brewery serving finely crafted European bar food and hard-boiled eggs, almost 8 dozen eggs daily for their deviled eggs, which is really cool. Now, cooks improvise at least 2 different fillings each day. Now, there's 2 locations. There's the Beer Garden in Midtown and the Beer Hall in the Grove. Now, the deviled eggs are only available at the Grove, at the Beer Hall. That's pretty cool if you love deviled eggs. My brother loves deviled eggs. I'm gonna have to take him there and get his opinion on those. You can get the recipe link and learn more about it on Urban Chestnut by visiting the lifestyle section of stltoday.com. It's under food and cooking. Check it out. Russell's on Macklin is expanding. You know, there's that Southampton restaurant. They're transforming their upstairs to include a full bar, extend the dining space, and, you know, be able to host private parties there. They said they're really excited that they're able to have enough people wanting to come there that they get to expand. There's gonna be a new bar and snack menu that's gonna be introduced, and it's seasonally driven, of course, and handcrafted and locally sourced, just like their baked goods, sandwiches, breakfast items, and other dishes. There's several local craft beers will be on tap, and they hope to produce a signature house brew with a local brewery. Now expect to finish construction in early fall. If you want information, russellcafe.com. 2 of St. Louis diners were featured on America's Best Diners. Now this is cool. This is a list compiled using basically Foursquare of the 34 best diners. Of course, you know Crown Candy Kitchen. They top the list. At least for us, they top the list. They came in number 4. They have a rating of 9.3 out of 10 on Foursquare. According to most Foursquare users, you should try the BLT, and I can vouch for the chocolate malt myself. It's delicious there. Of course, Crown Candy is on Southwest Diner. Usually has a line. There's a photo of it, a line outside the door. Totally worth the wait. And number 24 on the list of Foursquare with a rating of 9 out of 10 was another diner, and the Southwest Diner, and you should try their biscuits and gravy or fiery scrambler. I don't know what a fiery scrambler is, but it sounds awesome. Now, the downtown St. Louis post office is returning for 24-hour access. Now, they had gotten rid of this. They weren't getting a lot of money. This is at the lobby at 1720 Market Street. They're bringing back the kiosk where you can go in there and you can buy stamps or you can weigh your packages and mail stuff off. It's going to be cool. So that's going to be open. You should definitely check that out. All right, we are going to be moving right along. I've got a really awesome guest right here. He is in the mix, in the Daily Mix. I'm so glad to have you here, Kevin. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
All right, let's talk a little bit about what you've got going on. Tell everybody, for somebody who's not aware, what have you got going on that's really cool?
I'm the director and showrunner of Local Ambition. And Local Ambition is a modeling competition reality series that we shoot here right in St. Louis. And we finished production on our 4th season back in July, and it's set to air next month.
That's awesome. Now this is kind of, I'm gonna say this and I don't want to sound rude, it's kind of an odd thing. I don't look at you and think, this guy is really into modeling shows. I just don't. So what got you inspired on this?
I never thought that I would do it. You know, if you would have asked me 5 years ago if I'd be interested in something like this, I would just said no. But I had watched Top Model a long time ago, and for some reason it just kind of resonated with me. It was fun to watch because the modeling industry is something that people have seen in magazines and TV, but you really don't know anything about it. But they kind of exposed it and shed some light on it, and I thought that it was interesting. But, you know, fast forward 2012, you know, because first season of Top Model was a long time ago.
Yeah.
I was doing a podcast here in St. Louis, and the guy that I was doing it with wanted to do a modeling contest to drum up publicity for the podcast. And he wanted to just do a contest, but I wanted to turn it into a reality series because I just thought of watching Top Model. And I ended up doing it, but we ended up having, you know, a falling out. But I've kept doing the show ever since, and, you know, each year it just keeps getting better and better.
That's pretty cool. And what I read about you is that you have a really interesting, it's not like you have to be 6 foot and 100 pounds.
Sure.
Tell people a little bit about some of the interesting models you have on your show.
Some of the interesting models that we have, first one is Sarah Galbraith. She's a 33-year-old mother of three. She's from Jefferson City, and she is our first plus-size model.
Ah, there she is right there on our screen. There's a photo of her right there.
She is a size 16, and what she's doing is really important because she's breaking down barriers for plus-size women. She's showing that plus-size women do have a position in modeling, and that's not crammed in the back of modeling's closet. She's showing that plus-size women deserve to be right up there front and center with everybody else, even the size zeros.
Yeah, that's awesome. And we just saw a little bit of a clip of her there.
Yeah.
Tell somebody, you have a couple other really interesting ones I want to get to.
Another interesting cast member that we have this year is Hannah Hetz.
Yes.
Hannah Hetz is a 28-year-old native of Kokomo, Indiana. She's moved to St. Louis recently, and she's just a natural at modeling. She is the most tattooed model that we've ever had on the show. She doesn't even know how many tattoos she has. what's really interesting about her, though, is kind of how she develops over the course of the season. She's very much the alpha female of the group. She's a bulldozer. You know, nobody messes with her. Hannah's pretty intense.
That's awesome. Now, where can somebody watch the show?
They can watch it through our website at www.alwayslatetv.com.
Alwayslatetv.com. Now, you also have something called Brother and Sisters. What is this about?
Brother versus Sister is our first scripted series. We're taking a step away from reality, and we're, you know, diving into the world of scripted television. And we're start filming that actually next weekend.
You're already starting filming that in the next coming weekend. Mm-hmm. Now, did you write all of this?
Yeah. I've written it with two other talented writers, Kathleen Moody, who was a cast member on the last year's season of Local Ambition, and local actor Tom Murray.
Very cool. And where can people find out about that? I mean, I know that's not going to air for another year, but where can people find out more information?
They can find out information on Brother vs. Sister through our Facebook page at facebook.com/BVSALTV.
Awesome. Now, if somebody happens to be watching, and they're watching right now the little screen, we've got some of your models on there. You probably are going to do another season, I would assume, of this modeling show. It's going rather well for you. They can find that out on your website as well?
Right, yes. We are going to do a fifth season next year, and we're going to start accepting applications for it.
There you go. People listening, it's in November, he's going to start taking applications. All the information right there for Local Ambition is on your screen. Make sure you write that down, especially if you're interested in the modeling world, right?
Yes.
Awesome. Well, Kevin, thank you so much for coming
on the show. Thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it.
Stay here right with me. We're going to thank Kevin. And make sure you check us out on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. And drop us a line here at thedailymix@stltv.net. We want to hear from you. Maybe you're like Kevin. You got something really cool going on? Send us an email about it, babe. We'll have you come on the show. And that is going to do it for The Daily Mix, but keep it right here on STL TV and Experience St. Louis.